Anyway, let's get right into that. Obviously, I have not checked it out. This feels referential to any number of classic NES games. Though, of course, my title referenced Sega games. Or Sega advertisements in one case. Ah, this is who got the cyber razor cut. Now it all makes sense. That doesn't... I don't have the best mash, but, I'm a little bit disappointed with that thing not being, quite as mashable as I was hoping. Oh, we can't sprint here. Essence deprivation. Your vital systems can't hold out for long, Shadow. You're on borrowed time. To make matters worse, I'm pretty sure your awakening alerted Dr. Progen. Progen? Progen? Fuck, I don't know. We should keep moving. And that's our save. Presumably these are... I was gonna say extra characters, but... Fuck, I don't know. Certainly kind of feels like extra characters. And if you notice it not filling the entirety of the screen, that would be because I opted for the option that keeps it at integer scaling despite being full screen. And if it seems like it's filling a little bit more than you would maybe expect, that would be because it's not really going to be integer scaling as far as the viewer is concerned, because I have it being... Whoops. For some reason, I didn't expect that to be damaging. Because I'm doing 4K on my screen, even though there's no fucking reason to. Oh, I thought that was spikes. There's nothing here. I just saw a gap and thought it was spikes. Don't ask. Everything feels super responsive, which you would expect for a Yacht Club game. Like, everything just feels really nice. I'm just glad. Wait. Okay, now. Initially, it looked like, oh, that's Legion. Initially, it was looking like just standing there, we could get our, oh, that... That seems to attack ever so slightly quicker if you hit it in rhythm rather than mash. I'm not sure if that's a positive or a negative. Mostly because I'm really bad at actually keeping said rhythms. I'm actually tempted to turn off that flash. Oh, that's not. They're supposed to go down. I like the attack range. It's it feels really good. Sort of power up. Oh, our whatever the ninja magic that we had went away. So is good. But yeah, I know it's not exactly a surprising thing, but this, everything about this feels fantastic. Damn it. Which, you know, again, not surprising given the devs. Oh, I... genuinely had not noticed that attack coming all the way up. I really like that the restore points have an arrow directing you as to which way to go. Oh shit. Shit, that... I thought that there was no floor on the left still. That's why I had avoided going back. Well, I'm just playing poorly, but thankfully, as first boss, it's not astoundingly difficult. Ah, and I guess those little things that we saw before were health upgrades. So, one thing I am really liking, our attack is full height. Yeah. It covers the exact same. Space as our character's height. Possibly a little bit beyond, which, I mean, it's not really surprising. It's one of those things where it feels good. Amusingly, not having a duck actually feels good, since it was designed around. Damn it, I forgot that enemy falls. Yeah, I know, it'd been all of like 10 seconds since I'd last seen one. Falling through platforms works exactly as you would expect, down and jump. These turrets have 2 health, which, given that they close up after the first one, gets me pretty damn consistently. Yeah, I guess. No, it's... Yeah, that's why they get me, is because it really looks like it should. Well, that was rude. It should not have 2 health, because it has exploded. Master of timing here. Wow. I'm just not good at dealing with those jumpy boys. Oh, those can go just straight through platforms, so coming around was probably a good idea. I was not expecting that much knockback. I mean, it's appropriate for what it's trying to do style-wise, so... Oh, those are not coming quite as frequently as I thought they were. I nearly jumped into a pit as a result. Oh, we don't have a up attack. Interesting. Which of course means we did not have a great attack for dealing with that ceiling turret. To do that without getting hit. Surprisingly difficult when you kind of suck at movement like I do. Ah, that's why the electricity. And I did make the comment that, you can't really mash it, but it, that's not quite correct. Yeah, this art feels incredibly Sega. So I kind of feel like the master is going to be the final boss. So this guy probably has a second form once we get below the half health. Or at least a second set of attacks. I would be very surprised if it did not, anyway. Looks like I'm probably gonna be surprised. Oh, cannot quite reach him. Well, that's three instead of two, and that was marginally faster. I do like the combination of the cyborgs and... ninjas. Okay. Is that correct? I could have sworn I hit him in the back. Well, if I managed to avoid hitting him in the back, it certainly was not for lack of trying. Okay, so that takes SP, so we don't just have unlimited shurikens. That was just bad flying on my part. So these definitely take a lot more damage when their back is turned to you. Presumably because you were blowing up their power pack. Also, you need to hit them in said power pack. So that is a partial fill for the additional SP. Did that thing just fuck off? Oh, nice. Oh, that increases your range a little bit. Well, that's good to know. Also, I am fucking terrible at actually hitting those. Fortunately, there's a checkpoint right here. Oh, one thing I am absolutely in love with this game for. It lets you do same frame turn and attack. It feels... What? What I was going to say is it feels really good. Getting used to the better range of the other, having the upgraded attack. That really looks like a face right here. Is the not quite doorway. Ah, that's not gonna hit us. Okay, so we cannot jump a small enough amount to not die there. I had a lot more confidence in my ability to hit those things when... I had the little wave attack power up. Now I know there's nothing there, so... Damn, I was really close. Well, that was not my most clever move. That was just me being an idiot. Above and beyond anything else. That really wasn't too bad. I really, really like, the fact, what I was going to say there is I really, really like the fact that you get told which door is where you need to go forward. Ah, that's where that one came from. I assumed that it would have gotten killed by the spikes. So one thing I like is that your power-ups stick around for a certain amount of hits rather than like a certain amount of time. Now this is, of course, bad when you're terrible, but it's one of those things where, you know, like the speedrun I could definitely see not losing anything. Which is kind of neat. Ah, and those become more expensive. Got it. And those will get broken eventually anyway. Oh, that's not anything. Oh, it's something, but it's not anything useful for me since I don't use spirit. Because this is before an actual boss. I need to know. Okay. Oh, it's not an actual boss. I suspect there will be occasions where that bug enemy is less annoying, hazardous, than... Oh, it doesn't actually leave the gas break behind every time. I guess that depends on location rather than being a aspect of that particular enemy. So how far over does this one come? Okay. Can we jump high enough? Nope. Damn. Feels like we should be able to, but... Not quite. Need a slightly higher. Oh, this shit's hard to time. I guess it's more annoying to time than it is hard to time. Well, you see, it's pretty simple, really. Our clan fell prey to plot. Oh. Ah. Didn't notice the additional health. Oh, that. I wonder how many hits that thing takes. Or if it is even possible to, kill. Well, actually, I can check feats. Yeah, that defeats Scrambler without taking damage ain't happening. Yeah, most of these feats require you to be actually good at games, and, that ain't me. Mecha City. Hell yeah. Ah, so he made the robots. Robots. Ah, so he went batshit insane. But why is Legion okay? So we definitely saw our master already. Oh, that is actually a lot more, there's a lot more content here than I had anticipated. I just missed a basic-ass jump. That is... kinda impressive. In a how the hell did I get this far kind of way. Those are not breakable. They crumble, but and they leave. Are those spikes? I can't tell. I don't think they are. I think they're just kind of signifying that you, had something there. What? Well, fuck you two. game. I was sitting here thinking the background sewer was going to cause damage as well. Okay, so we can get... I need to know what it is. Ah. So it's not directly controllable. Not in the traditional sense. It is quite powerful, though. And it's just about depleted. Oh, it can... Actually... Oh, we can... Ah, fuck you too, game. Actually, I am a little bit curious as to... What the hell the, was over here? Ah! An additional point of health? Oops. Well, it's our essence now. Just as all of this is. This swag blade is pretty good. Pretty versatile. So there's almost assuredly a achievement here for not killing the green containers. Green enemies. Those things. I'm pretty sure it's not strictly necessary to kill them in any case. Oh, and that's a shortcut for if you die. Nice. Well, that didn't help you very much, bub. Ah. So it appears to have kind of static locations it hits. Please evacuate via train. Ah, so the way to deal with those is to just get close, and they blow themselves up. Because they're mines. Oh, I didn't realize that its hitbox was so gigantic. Oops. Is what it is. Oh, something... Did I get hit twice, or did something actually do 2 damage? I'm not a... Oh, those fuckers do 2 damage. That's kind of a strange decision. We're not that far into the game. I can already tell I'm going to hate the ever-living fuck out of this level. Because it's... Well, at this point, my feelings on it are... Yeah, it's tedious as shit to get back here. These enemies suck ass. There appears to be no health, but it's more likely that those enemies are just throwing the health, and it's functionally impossible to get said health, but, you know, technically there's health. Why the fuck aren't... And the lasers just don't come up as quickly as it feels like they should. Why the fuck did that hurt me? And I will also say that I really wish that the throw was on a button rather than a combo press. So need to take those out with the shurikens. Accidentally jumped a little bit too far, ended up actually being on said platform. So that's 2 HP we won't be getting back, but I mean that's fine, we got fucked by a different thing last time. Okay, I wasn't 100% certain as to what I actually needed to hit there to start, so... Well, once I knew what the hell I was doing, that wasn't anywhere near as bad as I expected it to be. So these are actually neat enemies, it turns out. This cutscene feels Genesis Shadowrun as hell. At least the initial part of it, anyway. God damn it. Oh, and I missed the plus HP. Cool game, don't let me jump in an area where you're just straight up not giving me any fucking HP. That's cool. Oh, it's different. That was neat. I got hit by the first and third ones. That feels good. That enemy certainly doesn't just feel shitty each time you end up getting hit by it. Why the fuck is the end of its goddamn gun a hitbox? What the fuck? I got ground knockback in air while jumping up through a platform. Cool. Thank you. I wasn't gonna make it anything anyway. Not with 3 fucking health. Well, 1.5 health. I don't know why they're giving us HP upgrades if everything's just gonna do 2 fucking health. Which, at the moment, everything that I have come across for the last fucking while has done 2 fucking health. I don't remember the last time I actually got to see something that did 1 health of damage. Maybe that thing did? I don't fucking know. I wasn't paying any goddamn attention. Cool. So even if you're on the platform, that can actually drop you down through the platform for reasons. I'm sure there are good reasons, I just don't, you know. Understand them. Okay, but, oh, that's just death. Good to know. Or it's the way forward, but it's not useful now. One or the other. I'll keep the shield for now, even though it's not gonna last very long. Okay. I think that's the way to do it. That jump is surprisingly difficult, though. I think I just need to be further out for it. Okay. Or not. And of course that does 2 damage because fuck you. So we have 5 hits of damage. Coincidentally, we started off originally with 5 pips of health, so our health is exactly the same as it was at the start of the game. Even though we found an optional health container. We could actually be in a worse state than we were at the start of the game, which is impressive. Oh, fuck you. That was just me misreading. But hey, now we're coming into the second part with 4 health as opposed to, what, 2 health? So now we have a, downstab. I really wish it did not cost, SP though. Actually, this strikes me as possibly an optional. Well, that is incorrect. This is the optional. What? That one, that requires a lot of SP. Two, Jesus. Oh, even if you don't have the SP for it, you can still get. That's good to know. I wonder if it still will break these things, though. Yep. Hell yeah. Okay, that's not near as bad as I expected it to be. Hmm. Oh, that's nice. Even without, Is that? That's definitely death. We can swim. That's actually legitimately surprising. So now we're going to get actual water techniques. Ah, hello. Definitely not Ryu. Hello, definitely not, Celeste. Is that just saying that there's... Okay. Yeah, that wasn't too bad. Nice. It's weird. This feels really odd because you move up so much faster than you move to the right. Ah, now we can get this easy. But of course, how the fuck do we get? Was there another route in here? I don't believe so. It's not gonna work. So what's off to the left here? No. This might be the actual way forward. Yep. Okay, so that activated something. Presumably it was important to come here. Ah, it activated one half of the door. I wonder if we need to actually hit up the checkpoint. We haven't needed to hit up the checkpoint, re-hit up the checkpoint, I guess I should say, for anything else. Which is, you know, kind of ruled. We actually have quite a bit of essence. And part of that is I'm averse to spending it, since it seemed like the few times we have spent it, it's gone up in price. Or things have gone up in price as a result, I guess is what I'm really trying to say. Well, that. Thank you. mark that marks, yes. Those things are kind of annoying. Everything hits real hard here. Not really surprising, but annoying to be sure. For some reason, the hologram is feeling very reminiscent of something. Charge Blaster. Yeah, I probably should do Spirit Recovery as well. Fuck you two, game. Oh man, if you wait for that to get charged, that's seems like it'll be real powerful. Yeah, the damage seems to bear that out. Yeah, and since there's no real negative to me going back right now, and I get an additional Charge Blaster, Hey, a scientist. Wow, fuck that guy. Feels strange that those enemies don't get knocked back. Oh, that's an exit. Oh, that is what we needed. God damn it. Actually, I think that's going to be it for me. This game is a little bit much for my hands. Thank you for watching, though.